It's lights out and lift off for MotoGP in 2022 in Qatar. Not a bad start for the pole man Jorge Martin, although big, big moment. The two reps, London's going to wait brilliantly. Marc Marquez gets the whole shot. Pol Espargaró slots into second. The initial launch good for Martin. Then he got it bogged. Big moment. But it's the two Repsol Hondas who lead.
From Brad Binder, who's up into third place. He's trying to go right around the outside of Marc Marquez. The two factory Ducatis had terrible starts.
Brilliant by the world champion, ex-world champion, Juan Mir. Just sticks his leg out there. Maybe an apology quickly to Enea Bastianini. He got through on the Italian at turn 15. Then it's Mir. Alexis Espargaró trying to get on in this podium battle as well on the factory Aprilia.
And Juan Mir, who we expected to go forwards, is going backwards. That's Alexis Espargaró picking him off.
Yeah, Mir's getting a bit beaten up here, isn't he? Getting a bloody nose. The former world champion Miller must have some kind of problem then, is that?
Alexis Espargaró, he's hot on the heels and up the inside, is he? No, not quite, of Marc Marquez. But that Aprilia that impressed us through pre-season testing is living up to billing.
Here comes Alexis Espargaró. There's nothing wrong with the top speed of that factory Aprilia as well. Can we see the Espargaró brothers soon to be fighting together for the podium?
Here comes Alexis Espargaró up the inside and he leaves an elbow on Marc Marquez. Marc Marquez did not expect an Aprilia to be coming past him in the first Grand Prix of the season, but Alexis Espargaró with some serious pace up into P4.
There's been missed opportunities, hasn't there, in the past of Pol Espargaró. He's been so tantalisingly close to breaking his Premier Class victory duck.
Pol Espargaró, look, he's already looking if he's making a bit of a gap out of the front. He's a quarter of a second, three quarters of a second, should I say, clear.
Pol Espargaró, this will be a popular win if he hangs on here with 10 laps to go in Qatar. He was really put through the mill last year, battered and bruised so many times. That Honda last year, the really unruly Honda, really did spit him and chew him up last season. But Pol Espargaró looking so, so good. Look at that gap coming down here. Enea Bastianini, we talked about it so many times last year. He was the master of tyre preservation. How many times did he come from so far back? He's just set the fastest lap of the Grand Prix. A 1:54.338. It's very much game on here now in Qatar. Pol Espargaró was quickly being reeled in here by the impressive Italian. Pol Espargaró trying desperately to cling on here to what will be a famous victory. There he comes.
Straight past Pol Espargaró. Can Pol Espargaró get back past? Does he have any grip on the brakes to get past? No. Bastianini gets his stop to Pol Espargaró. In fact, runs wide into turn one.
That's game over for Pol Espargaró. He did that in one of the Grand Prix here last year.
Brad Binder's got past Marc Marquez crucially as well. Brad Binder up into second place.
Wow, the mistake from Pol Espargaró now means that it's Binder back on the podium.
Yeah, what an incredible podium we're potentially staring at. Three laps to go as they come across the line now. Brad Binder has just kept himself in the fight. He's not faded like we thought he might. With those medium tyres, they're really helping him in the closing stages of this Grand Prix.
What a night as well for Red Bull KTM Factory Racing, with Brad Binder on course to take a podium. A dream start for new team manager Francesco Guidotti. Congratulations to Brad Binder. He takes second for KTM.
And look at the joy in the Red Bull KTM Factory Racing squad. KTM, an incredible start to the season.
Bastianini, it's in his hands now. What an emotional win this would be. Oh, this team was set up by Fausto Grosini before he tragically lost his life just over 1 year ago to COVID-19. And Enea Bastianini on course for what would be a truly emotional and remarkable win. What a way to kick off 2022 in MotoGP. It's all about one man and one team. Enea Bastianini on the Grosini Racing Ducati. Enea Bastianini surely on course for a famous victory. The beast reigns supreme in the Middle East. What an emotional victory for Enea Bastianini and the Grosini Ducati team. Nadia Padovani, Gigi Deligna alongside there as well. Davide Tardozzi, these are unforgettable scenes. We'll be right back.